these knives up. This is the Ganzo. Or not Ganzo, Global. No chips. This is a knife I got on Amazon for a long time ago. No chips. And the Kohetsu. Eogami Super. No chips. Alright. Let's start with this knife. This is a Shapton Pro 1.5K. This was finished on the Cerex 1000, but since I didn't like finish the edge, I needed a, and my parents needed a knife to use in the kitchen, they started using it, so just to kind of take out a little bit of wear, put it on the stone, reset the edge a little bit. Very hard stone, and it's, it leaves a very nice, like, matte finish. I really enjoy it. This is a spot that isn't forming a burr. Alright, we're good. Some finishing strokes on here. Stone, or this knife has like a 400 grit edge on this, so this stone is actually refining the scratch pattern as well. I think this can handle a 400 grit scratch pattern. I finished it on an India, like a fine India. probably spent a bit too much time there. Nope, not enough. Yeah, I missed my angle. I don't know what. Don't really have a very visible burn. Pretty solid burr there. So that was the 1.5K. I think This is a natural stone from China. You can get these at Woodcraft for like $20. And yeah, it's not a great stone. It doesn't really polish that well. It works very slowly, but it is a joy to sharpen on. It's a very hard stone. It won't release abrasive very easily, but it's very easy to scratch and gouge. Well, not gouge. It's very hard to gouge, actually. I don't think you can. Or you can, but it's very hard to gouge, but it scratches very easily. We're getting a bit of a polish, though. I hope you can see this. We had a couple good cuts in there, but yeah, for me that's good enough. Alright, so these guys are like, this got broke as well, but it's like a $27 stone. I could recommend it. Alright, I'd say this is done. I usually strop with knives, but not stropping today because I'm just playing with getting edges and finishing edges without strops. So I want to try and explore. This is a Naniwa Hasabusa 4000. It's a splash and go stone. It absorbs a little bit of water though for the first couple minutes, I guess. Not like it'll throw bubbles, but the water will just absorb. It's a softer stone, like you can gouge it pretty easily, you can see that here. But it just loads, it doesn't release abrasive at all. This is just a normal water bottle with a small X cut into the top. Got the idea from Michael Christie. He does that. I'm gonna try and use a guard. This is a King. It's supposed to be, it's called a 6,000 grit Nagura. I don't know if it's 6,000 grit, that's, I don't know. People say it's not. I'm not really using it for slurry, I'm just using it to clean. Make sure you wet your Nagura first if it absorbs water, because if it absorbs all the water, it's gonna stick to your stone, and once stones start sticking to each other, or plates start sticking and stuff like that, that's how you get broken stones. I'm not speaking from experience, I'm just heard it a lot. Global knife. See, no slurry, just loads. Very little swarf as well. I'm using a decent amount of pressure. I'm pushing down. Stone is a good polisher as well. I don't know if you can see that, but nice polish. A little less pressure, I don't know why, but ooh. Getting some weird feedback. My angle too high? No, I think, I don't know. That was a bit of a slice. Yeah. I wish that I had one of those faster best machines. I have a best reader, but it takes a darn long time to use to set it up. I think I'm gonna do best readings on these edges though. Now we're going on to the elusive Naniwa Fuji 8K. This is, I've only heard of this stone from a couple people in the straight razor community. It's a very legendary stone. This is the only stone that I've heard people say that was better than the Naniwa Snow White 8K. The Snow White has a lot more notoriety, but for straight razors, I heard this was a better finishing one. But I'm not a straight razor guy, and so I'm just blabbering shit I don't know. So, whatever. I don't know. Doesn't bother me. This one also doesn't release abrasive, it just kind of loads. It polishes so nicely. The 4K polishes like a 6K, and this polishes like a 10K or something. Let's see how this turned out. Feels like there's still a burr on here. Let us see though. Come on. Little fuck. Alright, well. Paper's very crinkled. bit of a slice to it. It's a decent thing, decent edge. I want to play around with finishing off the stone because Jef Jewel got a 60, a fucking 60 off a Sahiro. G8. Fuck. And that's insane. NorthWest Knife Guy is fucking bananas too. He gained really good results. Let's get some paper. Foam book paper already has like cuts in it, so it's not really that great, but this is like a different type of foam book paper that's pretty thick. I will do this knife in another video, or I just won't. I want to finish that knife on J-Nats, but this video is already 25 minutes long. Alright, this is a 3.5 micron diamond strop on felt. The diamond compound is Veneve, their diamond compound. I was like a sample pack of like 8 compounds. That was a bit high on the angle. Ooh, that feels really sharp. I don't know if I made like a wire edge or something, but oh my god, that's so aggressive. That probably means there was a micro burr and I just honed it into a very big burr or wire edge. Oh my god. What? Gosh, this is like, that's insane, holy shit. So aggressive, oh my gosh. This... wow, oh my goodness. All right, I gotta best test this thing. This is just I think this is like a 5 to 3 micron. That's like a range. Wow, felt really killed it. I don't want to bring it down to the 1 micron and the 0.25 because I feel like I'm going to ruin it. Jeez, man. And my stropping technique was off. There's rubbing alcohol. Wow, dude, holy crap. It's a nice edge. Feels really nice. Alright. So let me show you guys my best tester. This is, I believe, to be the most accurate version. Because it's manual. And that means like you add weight really slowly. You're very consistent as where you put the media. And yeah, if the edge is set right and I don't have a burr or anything like that, I will get the same exact result over like 5 tests. Now, if there's a burr, the result will be all over the place. And people misunderstand that, like, how small burrs can get. Just because you strop doesn't mean you don't have a burr. Most people who finish their knives have burrs at the end. I need to get a scale. Give me a second. Alright, I also have a hair. So, you probably won't be able to see this, but just cut through the hair there. It's not cutting on contact, though. I never whittle hair like this, but it should be doing better. Okay, so I don't know for sure because I never whittle hair with a knife clamped, but that was kind of a disappointing result. Alright, let's see. Alright, so that's 50 best already, because this whole piston thingy, whatever it's called, weighs 50 best. Then you add water until the line cuts. That's around like 90. Probably still a very small burr on here. So, yeah. I think it's just wire edge. Let's get one more reading. Different part of blade. Usually, I've needed to go to like 0.25 micron to finish an edge so that there's no wire. I found that 0.25 on certain stropping media to be the perfect derouter. Alright, so those two best readings were within 1 point of each other. Good. This scale said 43. Or sorry, it said 47. And then... No, I think it said 43. So it's in within three points of each other. Alright, now I'm gonna see how well the knife does on hair. I don't have a light set up, so you're probably just going to have to trust me if you can't see it. Yep, it is not doing so hot. I can force it into it. You know, if you pinch the hair and you cut right up against it, it'll go. You can usually force a knife to whittle hair that way. But, that doesn't mean the knife is fully deburred or derooted or whatever. Alright. One micron diamond paste on felt. This is just rubbing alcohol. Again. The edge is still very aggressive. A little less so. Cutting paper towel pretty nicely. Better. I can slice it, but it's kind of cutting on contact. Yeah, actually, it's doing pretty good. It's not perfect, but that's pretty good. That's actually like, that's no fucking joke, I guess. I don't know. Definitely, it's something to scoff at. It's definitely not, like, I'm not trying to act prestigious or anything. That was, definitely a very high caliber result, but I've been watching too much Northwest Knife Guy, so. And his edge is a little hair to a different fucking caliber. Alright, we're at 50 best then. Alright, we're at 37 for the first reading. So 37 plus 50, that's around 90 as well. So off the 3.5 microns drop, we had like a 90 relatively, we had a 100 relatively, and now for the first reading after the 1 micron, we have an like a just under 90, and let's see what we get for the second one. You have to give it a second. So that's just below 80. So 80, we're getting somewhere. 80's pretty good. Dude, Jef Jewel got a fucking 60, man. Jeez. I don't know, maybe it's like you get easier results with when you can just like press into it or something. I don't know, because the speeds are different. I don't know. All I know is I get consistent results with these guys, but all of edges that like, when they whittle hair, they don't, there's absolutely no competition. I've never seen any edge that like outperforms it in all the other testing categories except for best testing. I don't know if it's the tester, but you know, whittling hair, cutting cigarette paper, cutting paper towels, right, cutting tissue paper, right, I've gotten edges that, you know, I haven't seen, you know, a level of sharpness that I couldn't get in every other test. except for this. And I don't know if it's because I don't have one of those scale things, but because I've never been able to get below 50. I don't know. I think I'm making shit up. I don't know. I'm just I'm upset because I'm jealous. Northwest knife guy. This is a 0.25 micron. A little less aggressive as well. Alright, if this is not just obliterating hair, then I messed something up in the sharpening. It's decent. Yeah. Maybe my angle was a bit too high. Because I did this freehand, so I probably had a bunch of high strokes. Yeah, it's not consistent. It'll whittle hair and it'll cut hair no problem, but I have to tap the hair a couple times before it'll do it, which means the edge is not consistent. I think this is a good progression. I like the progression, but I don't know, I haven't been doing a ton of freehand sharpening, so definitely need to work on my skills a little bit. So that's a 22, so we're just around 70. Not even down to 60 yet, man. Not even down to 60. Jef Jewel, he's funny because he like underestimates. He always is like, I can't really whittle hair, you know? Just acts like he's not that good, which is total bullshit. He's really fucking good. He got a 60 off the stone. Oh, shit. You see, man, I jumped. Alright, so that's it. So, I have a... is 11 right here, so that means we're at about 60. I'll do another reading. So same exact thing. Alright, well, 60 best, I mean, add some hair again, because it was kind of miserable on hair. I'll do the bottom of the blade, so. I mean, that's pretty good, yeah. Yeah. I don't know, man. Crafting is just fun. It's really cool. I'm sorry I took up so much of you guys' time. Couldn't get to the point earlier. That was wet. Oh, before you guys go, if any of you guys are still here, yo, if you're watching this far, I have to know who's going this far. If you're watching this far, type in the comments, Rizla Green, RIZLA, space, Green. So then I can see who actually got this far. Nope. Wow. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Huh. Cool. All right. Well, yeah, thank you guys for watching so much.